Hello and welcome to Siddhganga Academy YouTube channel. Today we will be discussing the current affairs for 4th May 2021. And along with that, we'll also discuss the revision questions as well. We have around 8 articles. We'll discuss all these 8 articles in detail. Let's start. First article is about the health emergency. One of the ministers in Maharashtra has talked about this health emergency. So it is not of much importance. It is the criticism of the central government by the Maharashtra minister, but let's not go into that. What is of importance for us is the health emergency. Let's understand this health emergency. What are the provisions that we have? Before this, what I want to appeal to all of you, everybody stay at home unless it is very much urgent, not to come outside, especially the youngsters. You might be hearing about the silent hypoxia. So it'll silently reduce our oxygen levels in our body when we are affected by the corona. So since we are youngsters, we may not feel the breathlessness at the end. At the end, it will create a lot of problems, which will lead to a lot of emergency care. So let's not be overconfident of our immune system as well. At the same time, let's be very cautious of our health as well. So with this, let's start with the articles. The first article is it's talking about the health emergency. So one of the ministers in the Maharashtra government has criticized the central government, Modi government, about the emergency. He's asking to bring the health emergency. Let's understand. This health emergency. Do we have any constitutional provisions for this health emergency? To be specific, we do not have any health emergency provisions in our constitution. Let's look at the Article 352 of our Indian Constitution. It talks about the national emergency. It talks about the national emergency. So, on what grounds the emergency can be declared? If there is a war, or if there is an external aggression or an armed rebellion inside our country. Earlier, this was internal disturbance. Internal disturbance. But we all know about the emergency that was declared by our late Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. So using this provision, she had declared the emergency. So in the 44th amendment of our constitution, so this was taken out. And what was brought in? The armed rebellion was added to the constitution. It was replaced with the armed rebellion. Earlier, it was internal disturbance. So, let's look into the internal disturbance. Even this internal disturbance did not cover the health emergency. But we all know about the Sarkaria Commission as well. Why was this Sarkaria Commission formed? It was to examine the center and state relationship, the central government and the state government relationship. So, in that, they had mentioned about this internal disturbance. What they had said about internal disturbance was that it was meant to convey something more than simply internal violence. Internal disturbance may even be nature made and would include epidemics, earthquakes, cyclones, etc., which may paralyze the government of the state and put its security in jeopardy. So the Sarkaria Commission mentioned about the health emergency or the epidemics. This word was there in the Sarkaria Commission report, but not in the constitution. So it was talking about the internal disturbance, this sentence from the constitution. Since the 44th amendment of the constitution has taken out this internal disturbance, now this doesn't make much sense. The article 355 of the constitution basically was to support the article 352. How should the union government should protect to uphold the emergency provisions? Since this has been taken out here, but still this internal disturbance, this phrase still remains in Article 355, but it doesn't make sense because it has been taken out from the Article 352. From this, we understand that explicitly we do not have any constitutional provisions to declare the health emergency. But we all know about one more article, that is Article 360, which speaks about the financial emergency. Financial emergency. Since we know the COVID is also affecting many industries, it is also affecting the jobs of many people, it is also affecting the livelihoods of many people. So from this, we can understand that we are facing the financial emergency. So it is the interpretation, finally, how the constitution is interpreted. As Dr. B.R. Ambedkar said, effectiveness of the constitution depends on the people who implement the constitution. So we can implement in this way, but I don't know how far it will be right. But you should remember what is Article 360, Article 352 and Article 355. We do not have explicit provisions in the Constitution of India to declare a health emergency. So this is about the article about the health emergency. next is about the talking about the local state elections that were held recently, and also the results were declared. So there was a survey conducted by the CSDS Lokniti. What is CSDS? Center for Study of Developing Societies is an Indian research institute for social sciences and humanities, and Lokniti is a research program of the CSDS, which was established in 1997. So they have conducted the survey and they have conducted the analysis. So according to them, what matters for the assembly elections is the local issues. The local issues matter a lot for the assembly elections. So the assembly elections and the parliament elections, they are totally different. They are fought on different agendas. So local issues matter a lot for the assembly elections, that is the state assembly elections. But whereas the national elections, they are fought on different agendas. So from this, we understand that local matters or local concerns, local problems of the people matter a lot for the assembly elections. And in the survey, they had asked the question as to whether any particular national issue made an impact at all of them. So the answer for that was the Citizenship Amendment Act. So everybody mentioned about the Citizenship Amendment Act, which was brought in 2019. We all know there was a widespread protest in the country against this act as well. So most of the survey, the people expressed opinion against this CAA. Even now, we don't have this implemented. So let's remember, this might be not much very useful for your prelims, but for me, so no, you can make this, use of this. How the local issues or the local problems matter for the state assembly elections, and totally the central elections are fought on totally on the different agendas as well. Next article is talking about the Election Commission of India. We recently read in the newspaper that the Madras High Court had accused the constitutional authority, that is the Election Commission of India, that it had mentioned it as the murderer. So they had told that it should be framed in the murder case. So that is why the Election Commission of India approached the Supreme Court. They had prayed to the Supreme Court saying that the Election Commission prayer, the media should not report any comments from the bench. So what was it asking? Any comments that are made in the bench. So when there is a hearing going on in the court, we get some wordings or some quotes from the judges. They utter some, they express their emotions, they express their anger, they express their frustrations while delivering or while hearing any case. So what they prayed was, media should not report such comments during the time of hearing. But what the Supreme Court said, we all know about Justice Chandrachud. What he has said, public interest is not limited to judgments. He is saying that, not necessary that the media should report only the judgment, but also raising of questions in the court hearing, a dialogue between the bar and the bench. All of these show the public whether there was genuine application of mind by the judges. So when we report such things, whatever the conversation that was happening during the time of hearing, so it will also help whether there was application of mind by the judges. So we all come across many judgments wherein we feel that judgment was not right. So there is always a debate going on whether the scrutiny of the judgment should be done by the people or not. So it's still a debatable question. But here what Justice Chandrachud is saying that, media should be allowed to publish what is happening during the time of hearing as well. So this was about the Election Commission of India. So finally, what they have said, media can report all the conversations that were going on during the time of hearing. Next question, next article is talking about the National Human Rights Commission. Oh, it's not a constitutional body. Why is it in news? Because Justice Pant has been named as the acting chief of the National Human Rights Commission. So Justice Prafulla Chandra Pant, a former Supreme Court judge, has been appointed as the acting chairperson of the National Human Rights Commission from April 25. Earlier, he was the member of the Human Rights Commission from April 22, 2019. So he was appointed as the member of the National Human Rights Commission. And the post of the chairman was vacant. Who was the earlier chairman? It was the H.L. Dattu. He was from Karnataka. So he was the chief of the National Human Rights Commission, but the post was vacant since December 2020. So now Justice Pant has been named as the acting chief justice of the acting chief of the National Human Rights Commission. So what are the criteria for electing the chairman of the National Human Rights Commission? It should be either the retired judge or the serving judge of the Supreme Court. So that is the mandatory requirement as per the act. So this you need to remember. Next article, it is talking about the UAE prize. What is the name of the prize? Sheikh Zayed Book Award. Why is it in news? A German philosopher named Jorgen Habermas has rejected this award. So Mr. Habermans was named the cultural personality of the year, a distinction that carries a cash prize of 1 million dirhams. It is UAE currency. Why did he turn down this prize? Because he was against this hereditary rule that is taking place in the UAE from long. So since he is a philosopher and his writings are basically on the human rights, morality, democracy, he is most famous in Germany, and his writings have triggered a debate in Germany as well. So since he is working on all these things, he has definitely his rejection of this award is justifies, because UAE is a hereditarily ruled country. There is no elected government there. There is a king who rules the UAE. So that is the reason he has rejected this. So to understand more about the award, what is this award? Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan. So he was the first president of the United UAE. So United Arab Emirates. So you have to remember what is the name of the award. Oh, who was the philosopher? He is Habermans, and he is from Germany. This article is about the deputy governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Ravi Shankar has been appointed as the deputy governor of the Reserve Bank of India. This you have to remember. So earlier he served as the IMF consultant between 2005 and 2011. And also he holds the Master of Philosophy degree in the economics from the Jawaharlal Nehru University. So you have to remember this name, Ravi Shankar, and he is appointed as the deputy governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Next article, it's talking about the coronavirus. What are the variants of concern? So we keep hearing this term variants of concern. What is this variants of concern? The World Health Organization declares this variant of concern for what? For different viruses or bacteria. So we come across many variants when we talk about the coronavirus. We talk about the UK variant, we talk about the Brazilian variant, we talk about the South African variant. We also have the double mutant variant in India. So the variants which here we can see what are the variants of concern comprise. They basically transmission is very fast in these variants of concern, and disease severity of the disease that they cause is very much they are very much severe, and though they escape the immunity cover of the vaccination, even though the vaccination doesn't work against them. So World Health Organization declares the variants of concern for different variants of the viruses. To know more about the coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2 genome is single-stranded. It is a RNA virus. This you have to remember, because in the examination, they might ask you whether it is a DNA or the RNA virus. So since it is RNA viruses are more error-prone than DNA viruses, that is the reason we are seeing many variants of the coronavirus, which is a RNA variant, RNA genome. So from this we understand. So what is variant of concern declared by World Health Organization? The corona is the RNA variant. And what are the lessons that can be learned from this experience is the critical importance of the biomedical research we need to have, and the capacity for building for saving lives and economic growth as well. So the second way we did not predict, even though we had a lot of information from the health ministry and many research and the think tank, but our government did not focus much on it. So that is the reason we are having this second wave, very severe wave, many young people are losing their lives. So from this we have to understand in future also, we have to be very careful, and our government needs to focus more on biomedical research and capacity building. We are all looking and running around for oxygen cylinders now, but it's at this point of time to have all those things, it's a very expensive. But if our government was ready in advance, it would have been more easy for the government to handle the situation. And now we are seeking help from other countries as well. Okay, next article, talking about one of the varieties of the snake. It has been found in Western Ghats. Why is it in use? This snake called the Xylophis deepaki. It is the wood snake. It is the wood snake found in Western Ghats of India. So it is being named after the herpetologist Deepak Veerappan. Deepak Veerappan. That is why we find the name here, deepaki. So herpetologist Deepak Veerappan, his name is used to name this wood snake as the Xylophis deepaki. And the species is named in the honor of the Indian herpetologist Deepak Veerappan for his contribution in erecting a new subfamily, Xylophinae, to accommodate wood snakes. So he was the one who raised this subfamily called the Xylophinae. So what are wood snakes? They are harmless, they don't bite. They are fossorial and often found while digging a soil in the farm and under the logs in the Western Ghats forest. They feed on the earthworms, possibly other invertebrates. And interestingly, their close relatives are found in the Northeast India and Southeast Asia as well. So not just in the Western Ghats, they are found in other parts like the Northeast and the Southeast Asia as well. But you have to remember this Xylophis, Deepaki, is the wood snake named after a herpetologist, Deepak Veerappan. So with this, we'll be completing the discussion on the current affairs. 4th May, let's discuss some of the revision questions. The first question, does the Indian Constitution have explicit provision of the health emergency? First option, Constitution explicitly mentions the health emergency. Second option, health emergency is not mentioned anywhere in the Constitution. Internal disturbance in the Constitution implies health emergency also. D, none of the above. The first statement is wrong because there is no explicit mention of the emergency in the Constitution. And second one, health emergency is not mentioned anywhere in the Constitution. This is the right statement. Third statement, internal disturbance in the Constitution implies health emergency. So nowhere it implies, but only the Sarkaria Commission had talked about this. It had given a meaning about the epidemic for the internal disturbance, but nowhere in the Constitution it specifies. So the right answer is B here. Second question, which of the following about the National Human Rights Commission are correct here? It's a constitutional body. Prafulla Chandra Pant is acting chairman. Anyone can be appointed as the chairman. Here, it's not the constitutional body. It is the right here. Prafulla Chandra Pant is acting chairman. Anyone can be, no, it's not anyone. It's only the judges of the Supreme Court can be appointed. So the right answer is only two. So I'm sorry for that. Here you can make this as two only. This option you make it as two only. So two only is the right answer here. Third question, Sheikh Zayed Book Award belongs to which country? Iran, Iraq, UAE or Qatar? The right answer is UAE. Who is Ravi Shankar? Governor of RBI, Deputy Governor of RBI, IMF Consultant or none of the above? He is the Deputy Governor of RBI. Question and the last question. Xylophis, Deepaki is a snake, butterfly, frog or ant? The right answer is snake. It's the wood snake. With this, we'll be completing the current affairs discussion for 4th May and also the revision questions as well. Thank you.